हेलो क्लास एट, होप यू आर फिट एंड सेफ एट होम चिल्ड्रन। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज़ योर इकोसिस्टम। नाउ टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द ट्रॉपिक लेबल्स एंड फूड पिरामिड्स, फ्लो ऑफ एनर्जी, फॉरेस्ट इकोसिस्टम एंड इंटरडिपेंडेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म, दैट इज़ योर पैरासिटिज्म, प्रीडेटर एंड सिम्बियोसिस। Children, be regular with your studies and send your assignments regularly. As all of you know that this time in half yearly, 20 marks includes your assignment. So just be regular and send your assignments in time. Right? Now children, okay, now let's continue chapter 3, and first we will talk about the topic labels. Okay, now what are tropic levels? A food chain represents the flow of food in a given set of organisms or living beings. In a food chain, each step representing an organism forms a tropic level. So, in some most simple terms, tropic level means feeding level of the organism. The plants are producer, they constitute the first tropic level, and they fix up the sun energy and make it available for consumer. So herbivores, they constitute the second tropic level, and carnivores, they constitute the third tropic level. And large carnivores or top carnivores, they which feed on upon small carnivores, they constitute the fourth tropic level. So we can say that any ecosystem comprises of four tropic levels, namely the producers, primary consumers, secondary consumers and tertiary consumers. Okay, now next is your food pyramid. What is food pyramid? It is a graphical representation to show the flow of energy through different forms of life. It has a large base which continuously narrows when we move upwards. The base of the pyramid represents producers, that is your plants, and then herbivores, that is your primary consumers, and then secondary, and then finally tertiary or topmost consumers. In this way, what's happened? These pyramid is what? It decreases in size. Okay, now next is your pyramid of numbers. Now producers, they produce food with the help of sunlight by the process of photosynthesis. All consumers, they depend on producers for food. Now the graphical representation of the number of producers and consumers in a food chain is called a pyramid of numbers, which keep on decreasing when we move up towards the apex consumer. Okay, now next is your flow of energy. All of you know green plants, they use solar energy during photosynthesis and convert it into chemical energy. Now assume that 100% of the sun's energy is converted into food by the producers. 90% of the energy is used for various metabolic activities by the plant, and only 10% of the energy is stored by the producer, that is your plant. When herbivores eat the producer, only the 10% stored energy is transferred to herbivores. As this energy is not sufficient for herbivore, it feeds on more producers, and 90% of the total energy a herbivore receives by feeding on multiple producers is used up for the metabolic activities, and is stored only 10%. Now similarly, when the carnivores feed on a herbivore, if it receives the stored 10% of energy, this is again insufficient for the carnivore, and thus it feeds on more herbivores. This process continues up to a level after which there is almost no energy is left to be transferred. Hence, the energy flow along a food chain and the number of individuals at each level gradually decreases as we go higher up and creating a pyramid, right? So what is energy flow? It is the transfer of energy from the producer to the different levels of consumers along a food chain is called energy flow. Food chain is a feeding relations through which energy is transferred step by step from the producer to the consumers, and it is always unidirectional. Only 10% of the energy is passed in each tropic level, and the flow of energy gradually decreases as we go high up in a food chain. Okay, now next is your interaction between biotic and abiotic factors. All of you know an ecosystem is a living system which is formed by the interaction between the biotic factors and abiotic factors or in a habitat. Biotic factors are your plants and animals, and abiotic are factors are your water, air, oxygen, carbon dioxide, right, soil, temperature, these one. All of you know plants and animals, they breathe in oxygen and release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Plants take in this carbon dioxide to carry out photosynthesis, and then these plants are eaten by animals, right, which are plants and animals are biotic component. Okay, now next is your forest ecosystem. Forest ecosystem consists of the community of plants, animals, microbes and all other organisms in interaction with the chemical and physical features of their environment. Forest ecosystem includes abiotic components such as organic and inorganic substances present in the soil and atmosphere. It also includes dead organic debris. Now, biotic components include trees of different species, shrubs, other ground vegetation, and as well as different types of animals. So, flora and fauna, they make forest ecosystem. What is flora? Plants occurring naturally in a particular area are called flora, and animals occurring naturally in a particular area are called fauna. Both flora and fauna, they play an important role in maintaining the ecosystem in a forest. Okay, now next is your interdependence between organisms, that is your plants and animals. Plants depend on animals. All of you know insects and birds, they help in pollination. Grazing animals and plants, they disperse seeds of plants, right? Soil is made soft, aiding in plants' growth by earthworm. Dead remains of animals make the soil rich in nutrients, and carbon dioxide released by animals is used for photosynthesis in plants. Now, how the animals depend on plants? All animals directly or indirectly depend on plants for food. Plant products like oil and spices are consumed by the humans. Many animals, they find shelter in trees, and oxygen released by the plants is used by animals for respiration. Not only animals, but all human beings. So, animals, and actually all human beings also come under the animals. So, animals also depend on plants, and plants also depend on animals. So, we can say that animals get oxygen, food, shelter from plants, as well as purifies atmosphere, so that they can easily survive in this pure atmosphere. The same way, plants depend on animals for pollination and seed dispersal. Plants obtain nutrients from the dead remains of the animals. We now know that abiotic and biotic factors are interdependent in an ecosystem. An interaction occurs between the biotic components too. Means biotic, there is a interaction also takes place between biotic components, like symbiosis, parasitism and predation are some examples of interdependence. So first is your predation. What is predation? It is a relationship between two organisms such that one organism hunts down the others for food. The animal which hunts is called predator, while the hunted animal is called the prey. The relationship between cheetah and deer is that of predation. Now just see, these tiger and lion, these are predators. Means they kill other animals for food and eat their flesh and are called predators. Now prey, those animals that are killed by other animals for food are called prey. This deer, zebra, goat, they are called prey. Okay, now next is your parasitism. Parasitism is a relationship between two organisms such that one organism benefits at the cost of the other and often harms it. The organism which benefits is called the parasite, and while the other organism is called the host. For example, tapeworm is an intestinal parasite of man. The tapeworm absorbs digested food from the intestine, and this makes man weak and anemic. Other examples are fleas or ticks that live on dogs and cats are also parasites, and they live on the blood of the host animal. Next is your symbiosis. Symbiosis is a relationship between two different organisms in which both are mutually benefited, means both are what benefit each other, right? A symbiotic relationship occurs between rhizobium bacteria and leguminous plant. Actually, these are the bacteria which lives in the roots, root nodules of the Persis plant. Rhizobium is found in the root nodules of plants belonging to the pea family. It is a nitrogen fixing bacteria which convert nitrogen from the atmosphere into nitrogenous compound like nitrites and nitrates. These are easily absorbed by the roots of the legumes, and the plant in turn provide shelter and food to the bacteria. In this way, both are benefited. Okay, now next is your conservation of natural resources. All of you know what are natural resources? The resources which we get from the nature, and they all are essential for the survival of all living beings, whether they are human beings, plants or animals. Now, the water we drink, the food we eat, the air we inhale to survive are all either natural resources or they are obtained from natural resources. In absence of any of these resources, can you think that life will be exist on this earth? No. Now, the human population has, all of you know, it is increasing. Human population is increasing day by day, right? And naturally, with the increase in the population, there is a growing demand of the basic needs of humans. And these basic needs of human being, what? They are met by natural resources. Hence, the consumption of natural resources has increased. But the amounts of resources which are present in the nature, they are in limited. Okay. Hence, it becomes what? It's our duty that we use these natural resources wisely and judiciously. This judicious use of the resources in such a way that the resources can be used for longer duration of time is known as conservation of resources. It is important to conserve these resources so as to stop or control the misuse of these resources. The human activities that affected the natural resources in a negative manner. We now know that these resources are available in limited quantity. Hence, it becomes very important to conserve these resources. Thank you, children. And just go through this chapter. Okay, now your chapter is finished. And try to do all the exercises which I'll give you as a home assignment. Okay, thank you, children.